In this problem, we're going to examine a different coordinate system. Most of the time when working with vectors in linear algebra, we work with what's called the standard basis. So for instance, when we write down the vector, I don't know, x equals 1, 2, 3, that means we have 1 in the direction of 1, 0, 0. The 2 in the second coordinate tells me we move 2 units along the 0, 1, 0 direction. And then 3 in the third element would tell us that we move 3 units along the 0, 0, 1 direction. So the standard basis that we tend to work with implicitly just has a 1 in each corresponding coordinate of the vector. Sometimes we want to work in different coordinate systems, though. So for example, in this example, we're going to work with a basis B that looks like the following. It's not going to be, these are going to be length 3 vectors. The standard basis would be 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. In this problem, we're going to work with a basis represented by 2, 2, 4, a negative 1, 0, 3, and 1, 1, 1. It turns out that these vectors are all, they are linearly independent, so they form a basis for R3. So any vector in R3 I can write as a linear combination of these vectors, but obviously any vector in R3 that I would write as a linear combination of these vectors, those coordinates, would be different than how I would write the linear combination for the standard basis, which would be the vector 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So it's just a change of coordinate systems, so to speak. And in this first example, we're going to get practice writing a vector that has been provided in this coordinate system. And we're going to translate that back into what I would call the standard coordinate system. So this is the basis that we're working with in this problem. And we're provided a vector, and the notation we use is x sub b. And this tells us that the vector x has been written in the basis b. So anytime you see this square bracket with a subscript with a letter, that is basically just an indication that the vector has been written not in the standard basis, which is usually our implicit assumption there, but it has been written with respect to the basis B. So this vector is 2, 1, negative 3. So this is the representation of the vector in this basis, and it really tells us to move 2 units along this direction, and then move 1 unit along this direction, and minus 3 units in this direction. So the interpretation is still very much the same. It tells us how many units we've moved in each direction, but the directions aren't the standard directions. They're these directions specified by this new basis B. Okay, so that's a little explanation about some of the things we like to do in linear algebra. In this particular problem, what we're going to do is we're going to find x. We are going to find the coordinates of xb in the original standard basis. So how are we going to do that? The key thing is that x sub b tells us how to construct x from the vectors in b. So let's take a look at this. Let me go ahead and write down x sub b, and let's think about what each of these entries means. 2 tells us to move, like I said, 2 units in the b1 direction. So that this vector right here is a vector in the standard basis, 2, 2, 4, obviously. And this first coordinate tells us to move 2 units in that direction. The second coordinate tells us to move 1 unit in the b2 direction, where b2 is this second column. And a negative 3 tells us to move 3 units in the negative direction of b3, where b3 is this third column of the basis b. So we can go ahead and form this linear combination now to figure out what x is. X is going to be 2 times this first column, plus 1 times the second column, plus negative 3 times the third column. So if I go ahead and do my algebra there, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8. 1 times the second vector just gives me the second vector, and then a negative 3 times the third vector gives me a negative 3s everywhere. If I add all these coordinates up, 4 minus 1 minus 3 gives me a 0, 4 plus 0 minus 3 gives me 1, and 8 plus 3 minus 3 gives me 8, so I get the vector 0, 1, 8. So this vector right here is the vector x, and this represents the vector translated into the standard basis. So we've started with a vector representation in one basis, And using this interpretation of what this means, we've actually rewritten it in terms of the standard basis. So in some ways, this is kind of like a coordinate transformation problem. We had a vector representation in one coordinate system, and we were able to write it equivalently in a different coordinate system, where the second coordinate system is what we call the standard basis. It's the normal way that we tend to write vectors. And anytime we write a vector like this, that's what we mean. We imply that we're using a standard basis. It's only when we move to other coordinate systems and other bases, we use this slightly different notation to indicate this vector is not written in the standard basis. This vector has been written with respect to the basis B, and the basis B in this problem was this set of vectors.